some of us grew up up north.
Absolutely.
In New York, and I know, Stephanie, this story really hits close to home for Stephanie Berzinski. Her father survived in the World Trade Center during that 9/11 attack.
Yeah, I'm proud to say he is a survivor, and we especially want to thank firefighters who lost their lives, firefighters today who take care of us. My father said one of the things he remembers most is coming down the stairwell. He worked on the 64th floor, and he had to take the stairs all the way down, and he says he remembers passing the firefighters and seeing the look in their eyes, and that's when he realized that this was bad, this was major. There you see my dad. He's actually in Jersey City in that picture, overlooking the Hudson River. It's a memorial that shoots straight to the Freedom Tower and the area where the World Trade Center towers once stood. My dad lost about 30 friends and coworkers in the 9/11 incident. There's my hand on one of his close dear friend's names down at the Ground Zero Memorial. One of the jokes now is, like, my dad is kind of like a cat. He has 9 lives, and we're very happy and thankful for that.
Of course.
But he was there in the 93 bombing. It took him 8 hours to get out of World Trade One in February 26, 93. And then 2011, he got down in 1 hour thanks to lights that had been put into the stairwells. So that helped guide a lot of people down and saved a number of more lives. And today we're just grateful to have him around. Although there is still, you know, people talk about survivor's guilt. On my field hockey team alone, there were 3 of us. My dad came home, my other friend's dad was injured, and one of our friend's dads never made it.
Wow.
So sad.
Stephanie, thank you very much for sharing. I know that was not easy.
Thank you.
You got through it this morning. Thanks.